Researchers in Japan have developed a brain-machine interface that allows for control of a wheelchair using thoughts alone. In this video, released by government-affiliated research unit RIKEN, the thought patterns of the researcher are being picked up by electroencephalography, or EEG, sensors mounted on his head. The data is relayed to a laptop computer that interprets it and turns it into control signals for the wheelchair. The system was developed by RIKEN and Toyota Motor, Toyota Central R&D Labs, and Genesis Research Institute. With as little as 3 hours training per day for a week, the system can be trained to a particular user's thought patterns and achieve an accuracy rate of 95%. The interpretation process takes as little as 1/1000th of a second, which improves on the several seconds of other systems. And when things go wrong, an emergency stop can be performed by puffing out a cheek to activate a safety sensor. Plans to use the technology in a range of applications are already underway. First uses will likely center on the fields of medicine and nursing care management, with the BMI interface decoding brainwaves related to imaginary hand and foot control. But researchers are confident that they can extend its use to detection of brainwaves generated by various mental states and emotions with a little further research. Earlier this year, researchers at Honda Motor reported success in development of a BMI system that allows a person to control a robot through thought. The system allows a researcher to think one of several predefined movements, such as the robot lifting its right arm, and hopefully have the robot follow through with the same action. Honda said its system achieves a 90% success rate. Japanese car makers have built up expertise in robotics from their development of highly automated production lines and have been seeking to channel some of this knowledge into humanoid robots. Japan faces a rapidly aging society, and home health robots are seen as a potential answer to an anticipated shortage of healthcare workers in the years ahead. In Tokyo, this is Martin Williams, IDG News Service.